إن الحمد لله نحمد ونستعين ونستغفره، نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار، وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. Praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he's the only one worthy of praise. I seek his help, his guidance and his forgiveness. I believe in him and I trust him. I seek refuge in Almighty Allah from the evil of our passions. Indeed, whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides him to Al-Islam, no one can mislead him after Allah. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him astray, no one can guide him after Allah. I testify, O believers, that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah Rabbil Alameen. It's besides that share. I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger and the seed of all the prophets. O Muslims, you should fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the best of your ability. Have the taqwa of Allah and don't die unless you are in a state of Al-Islam. I greet you all with the greeting of Al-Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. I would like, before I start my class, to welcome some of my early students. 35 years ago, they are present here. We start with Sister Sadiqa, since she's in the right. Sadiqa Mu'mina from Brooklyn, New York. And she's one of the earliest students. And also, we go to the left and the youngest, and Sister Naima Abdullah, which is also one of the earliest students. And we're talking about 1975. Subhanallah, these beautiful days. And also, in addition to this, Sister Zainab also is here, Brother Habib's wife. So Brother Habib and these three sisters here are among the first early people that study under me. When you used to be Khalid Yassin and Imam Ibrahim and all these imams that you hear about, all these people used to be there in Brooklyn, New York. And also tonight we have Brother Majid, you understand, one of the earliest people that started also with us here, and this was in 1982, something like this. But alhamdulillah, so today we have most new and all the students, and alhamdulillah, I'm proud to have these people here today. Some of them coming to visit, and some of them, you understand, they stop by, and but it's good to see everybody, the new and the old. Nevertheless, we did not see the quality of people as in general all over the United States as used to be in the old days, because in the old days people were so eager to learn, and they used to come, travel, take the subway for an hour and a half, 2 hours to study. Today things became more scholars and more learned people, more masajid, more books. We remember when we used to go from Brooklyn to Manhattan to the what you call the village to get a translation of Yusuf Ali. It was only one bookstore that we know. Today you go on Atlantic Avenue, in one street you find at least 7 bookstores. But the quality changed. The quantity is more, but the quality had dropped a lot. But alhamdulillah that we still have some of those people that I look up to them to be like a seed for the future. And alhamdulillah we saw some of the seeds, that one of them, that Sister Naima, mashallah, she's in addition to her work there in university in Medina, we saw her two books, The Way of the Prophets. She's the author, or you may call it co-author, or what you want to call it. Okay, that she written these two books, okay, which we have them, and it's very, very valuable books. So alhamdulillah. And sister Sadiqa been very supportive person to the community, her family, her husband. And so some of you went to Brooklyn Souk and these places. And so this is the old days, and we have them here today. So this has given me uplifting, and feel happy to have these people, to see their faces again. But inshallah, we pray that Allah bless the old students and the new students. And we see that our class is dropping from 50 people to almost 5 people. I don't know, maybe the summer, or maybe because the people come to the Baisa in the morning. But whatever, we still try to keep on with the class as much as we can, broadcasting for those people who like to watch from their house. And this class, which we give in Tuesday, only to let those visitors be acquainted with what we're doing. We come every Tuesday for 1 hour, which we use to have 4 classes, one Arabic class, and one Quranic class, and one is Hadith class, and one is Salah. So basically, we had finished Arabic 3, and we review it again. We had accomplished this book, alhamdulillah. And we finished Surah Al-Ghashiyah, and hopefully some of you finished memorize it. Also, we had finished about half of the 40 Hadith Islamic School Part 1. We're still working with it, and we finished the Book of Salah. So this is some of the accomplishments that have been done through Tuesday. The good thing about Tuesday class, that is a mixture of different topic and it meet requirements of different types of people. Some people, they like Arabic. So when you come here, you get some Arabic and some Hadith and some Quran. So all you can eat for $5, okay, alhamdulillah. So Chinese or Japanese or Spanish, everything goes. As long as you go to be in Jannah, when you die, you okay, inshallah. Is it right, Sister Maryam? Believe it or not, I have three Mariams in my family now, so don't worry about it. You don't want to talk to me? I have three Mariams now. Okay? I got my daughter-in-law, Mariam, and I got my granddaughter, Mariam, and I got another granddaughter, Mariam. And we don't know who other Mariams will be coming in our life. But we pray all of us that Allah give us the taqwa of Mariam, inshallah. Let's take a sample, and for what we do on Tuesday, we take one hadith, and today we work in hadith number 25, and talks the title is gentleness. If you don't understand what is gentleness, remember being harsh and rough and difficult, all these things. So the opposite, sometimes you know the word by knowing the opposite, okay? To be sahl, easy going, like they say, sahl, okay? And to be rafiq and rifqa and all this terminology, parts of the deen. Hadith, Aisha radiallahu anha qalat, qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is hadith number 25, page number 49. An Aisha radiallahu anha qalat. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الله يحب الرفق في الأمر كله. Or you can say كله. When you stop, you drop it a vowel and became like a sukun. كله. Alright. There is another narration. This is the narration of Imam al-Bukhari, rahmatullah alayhi. There is another narration which is say, Inna Allah Rafiq, يحب الرفق في الامر كل. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is gentle. And that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves gentleness in all the matters. Hadith which we deal with it is from the Bukhari, Imam al-Bukhari rahmatullah alayhi, and the narration saying, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الرِّفْقَ فِي الْأَمْرِ كُلِّهِ. Narrated Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, that the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, indeed Allah loves gentleness in all matters. And gentleness, like I said, is the opposite of being rough, being harsh, being, excuse me, me too. Okay, I'm not sorry. Okay, I'm sorry. All right. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves gentleness. As a result of this, wa alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Wa alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Wa alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Okay. So three, we need one four. One to be, to make it four. So say Rafiq. Rafiq, rifq, gentleness, kindness, easiness, easy going. And this is the nature of this deen. As a result of this, as example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, since we're talking about Ramadan is coming, made Ramadan obligatory to fast. Is right, Iman, Islam, faith, all right. Ramadan to be what? Obligatory to fast. Nevertheless, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make exemption. Is this out of gentleness, rifq, suhula, yusr, okay? Not to be usr. فمن كان مريضا او على سفر او على سفر فعدتهم من ايام اخر. Those who are on a journey or sick, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exempted them from what? From fasting. If Allah wants them to fast, he will say, no, you have to fast. Okay? Doesn't matter. You're going to die, survive, or you make it or not. Doesn't matter. Later for you. You have to listen to me. And Allah can do it like this. But still Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say what? فَعِدَّةٌ مِّنْ أَيَّامٍ أُخْرَ. Okay? Water can be in existence, but it may be a bottle cost $5. Alright? Islam doesn't tell you go and buy a bottle of water to make wudu. Alright? No, you save this $5 to get a bottle of water to drink, so you can save your life, and for wudu you can make what? Tayammum. Dry ablution. Okay? So the same thing, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's the one who's the master, and he put the laws and rules and make things easy on us. So this also to teach us how to take things easy, okay? Take it easy. And this one used to be one of my famous expression in Brooklyn, New York in the old days, because I like the words that say the terms, and it became everything. I say, brother, take it easy, brother. Take it easy, okay? And in actuality, we try to take it easy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what? وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَضًّا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ لَنْ فَضُّ مِنْ حَوْلِكَ. If you've been harsh, hard-hearted, that the Sahaba will what? They're gone. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we found him, okay. Somebody come, even a munafiq, that says, oh, Prophet of Allah, my wife was about to give birth and I could not cut. Say, okay, no problem. It's time for jihad, to fight. And this man tried to make excuse, his wife was this. Oh my, the palm trees and the sun was about to grab and have to the harvest because the bees and the birds are about to eat it. Okay. May Allah forgive them. Go ahead and give them excuses, okay? And this is the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam seen, you understand, a camel, and the camel cried to the Prophet, and the Prophet understood what he was talking about. And the Prophet go to the Sahaba, ask, who is the owner of this camel? Okay? He said that he's complaining to me that you burden him with the heavy loads and you don't give him enough food and drink. Subhanallah. Okay? So you found Islam about easiness, about gentleness, even about things that what Allah make it halal for us and lawful to eat. You shouldn't be taking the goat as example, Kalim, huh? Dragging it by the tail or by the back leg and keep dragging it until for a mile and after this because, oh, I'm going to kill it, so it doesn't matter, okay? No, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, وَلْيُرِحْ أَحَدُكُمْ ذَبِيحَتَهَا وَلْيُحِدْ شَفْرَتَهَا one of you have to sharp the knife and relax the animal. You shouldn't take, you understand, okay, Eid Mubarak, brother, Bismillah, Allahu Akbar, and all the animals standing there. They will see, they will freeze the blood, you understand, in their veins. No, you take them, you understand, they have feeling. They have feeling, they can know, okay. You don't stand, oh, brother, and yes, and keep sharpening the knife, and the animal standing watching, like, you understand, ah, oh, my turn is coming. Even with animals. So if the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam telling you, well, you hiddu ahadukum shafrata, make your knife sharp. Don't to go and after say, oh, it's not working, man, go sharp it again. And try to, and you keep on going back and forth, back and forth. No, before is this, you know, it's supposed to have preparation. Take the knife, sharp it, have it ready. Okay? One shot, zabiha. All right, get it. Bismillah, Allahu Akbar, okay? This, even with animals. Can you imagine talking about children, talking about wives, talking about people who working for you, servant? The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says those people who are abid, slaves, okay? Although they slave in captivity, but they still are your brothers. They are a human being, okay, like you. But Allah made them to be subjugated to your order, under your position. So still, فَلْيُطْعِمُهُ مِمَّا يَطْعَمُ. That he's still your brother, وَعَلَيْكُمْ السَّلَامُ. Okay? He's not a free man, but still the Prophet ﷺ said what? He is your brother, but Allah made him to be under your supervision. So still feed him from what you eat. Dress him from what you dress. This is what Islam is about. Okay? So Islam talks about gentleness, kindness, to be considerate. Okay? Not you understand a person to get in an airplane and boom. Not you understand a load and bomb, you understand thousands of people in a minute like this. And as I say, brother, my country, I defending my country. You don't know what your country is right or wrong. They don't care about this. They go drop the things. The only thing, push a button, you understand? Drop all this load and villages and people get destroyed and because I make a living. This it. Okay? And this shows you about how cruel these people, you understand? This is not what's Islam. Islam talks about a goat and a sheep. Can you imagine if you take somebody in captivity? Okay? How are you going to deal with it? Can you imagine if you have a wife, what you do with it? Can you imagine if you have a child? Okay? So gentleness, we have to find alternative how to deal with people. All right? How to be kind to them. It does not everything have to be through harshness, through shouting, through cursing. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves gentleness. And he said what? Fil amri kulli. In all affairs. Doesn't matter if you're riding, if you... What about a half in a car? He said, brother, this is nothing except metal. It doesn't... Boom! And after this, and next thing, a couple of days, the engine is gone. He said, fil amri kulli, in all your affairs. Some people, they have brakes in their bikes, but you understand, they feel it funny, and button sneakers, understand, all the way in the asphalt, half of the sneakers is gone, okay? $150, half of it is gone, because after this you have a hole, you're going to throw it. Gentleness. Say, what are you talking about? This is the metal, and this is the shoes? No. Because Islam, it goes everywhere in your life, and wants you to be sensitive to everything, to the tree. To the tree, to the river, to the animal, to the human being, to the enemies. You understand? In a war, it's telling you a sheikh, an old man, a woman, a rahib, a person that is not in your religion. But basically what he's doing is worship. He's sitting in what you call it, a kuch, okay, a small house, worshiping Allah. He doesn't worry about who bomb, who not bomb. He's about his business, although he worshiping other than Allah. The Prophet ﷺ said, don't disturb him. This is what Islam is about, gentleness. And it has to be in all the affairs. And we can see the beauty of Islam, about gentleness, especially with our youngest. Why? Because believe it or not, we can be creating a bad future for Islam and Muslims, or we can have a better future. Because the way how you act, as a parents, as a father, as a mother with a child, this child, when they grow, they will have some inside them, in the back of their brain and their mind, how they've been treated, and they were going to be treating the children the same way. So gentleness, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam passing by kids, he's the Prophet of Allah, leader of a whole ummah. He didn't say, I don't have time for these kids. He stopped, wiped their head, talked to them, Ya Umair, ma fa'al anna ghair, kallan nazir, rola hasal eh habib, okay? All these things, this is the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. All right? Hold down, brother. Kindness. Thank you. All right, I can close. No rush. Zakallah khair. Okay, so the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam go and say, Ya Umair, ma fa'al anna ghair. Oh Umair, what is your bird? The Prophet concerned about his toy, his beds that he have in the house. What happened to it? Because he tried to elevate his spirit because he feel bad about his bird died.
Bird.
Yeah. Okay. So the Prophet, this is the Prophet. And when we say that we need the Sunnah of the Prophet, this part of the Sunnah of the Prophet. Being kind, being gentle, and this part of our deen, inshallah. So Islam encourages gentleness. Allah loves those who are gentle to others. A Muslim should be gentle and easygoing in all his affairs. To receive Allah's love, we need to show gentleness and love to others so we can be earning Allah's love. Thank you for being here. Again, a special greeting for my old students. Welcome to Colombia, South Carolina. And I hope you have a good stay in here before you go back. Hopefully, inshallah, that those brothers and sisters who are here today get to meet those old students and get learn something new. What it is? Steadfastness. To stick with the teacher. These people been 33 years. All right? They're still hanging there. We're still seeing them. We still understand, have communication with them. It's not to understand, you come, take a drop, we understand of this glass and keep walking. Until today, I didn't have one single student since I've been in Columbia, South Carolina, all right? But I can say that I have students that since I was in Brooklyn, New York, all right? And like I said, as example, like those people, but they became big shots now. Nobody know about them, like Khalid Yassin and Imam Abdullah and all these big stuff that you hear about them. But alhamdulillah, we are not here to, but we say that these people had benefit from the knowledge. And Imam Ayyub and Imam so-and-so and all these imams, they understand. So hopefully that we can learn something today that we need to stick to the teacher and really be students. And we try to appreciate the knowledge, appreciate the opportunity, and whatever left time left, you understand, with the student, with the teacher, Allah knows best, because we have the hearse waiting outside. We don't know who's going first, okay? But you should stick. And by the way, we can say that, but he didn't claim that I'm his teacher or his sheikh. But Brother Sabri would been sticking for Zala since 1885 or something, maybe?
Yeah,
so... But he didn't claim the relationship, but alhamdulillah, I appreciate it. No, brother. This is good.
By the way, we have someone that works at Levy's funeral, so he's really
so he knows what I'm talking about. But alhamdulillah, at least, so to be fair, one of the people that really stick with the work, okay, and we appreciate it, and he's been doing a lot, Brother Mutai Sabri. I'm not going to mention Habib, because Habib, we imported him from New York, okay? But Brother Sabri been sticking, you understand, with the mosque and when I hear some of his classes, because he gives class here in Fajr, and I be sitting, he's sitting in the chair, I be sitting in the floor, okay? I can hear and I can say alhamdulillah in my heart that I hear the echo, you understand, the tawheed, the sunnah, and the fadl. So I hope that some of you, inshallah, get to see here. Brother Sabri was talking that we have Sister Naima Abdullah is here, and we have Sister Sadiqa Janna Naima here, and some of these sisters that since 75, they are here present in the class today, and their contribution and how they, alhamdulillah. So we will try to say that the people today, inshallah, that they should try to learn something tonight, that there is a teacher, you want to call him a student of knowledge, Sheikh, Maulana, whatever, this is not the issue. You need to stick with this person, get something from the goodies that he have, because in case he depart anytime soon, that you really get something, you can pass it to other people, inshallah. Jazakumullah khair, and tomorrow, inshallah, we don't have a tafsir class, because most of the students of the tafsir class out of town, but we have about at least 40 children here, and counselors, so maybe we're going to have a special class tomorrow, inshallah, at, let's say, 7 o'clock will be good, so people can relax and be able to come, inshallah. There is no tafsir class, because most of the students are out of town. And there is no shura also tomorrow. But we have the overnight sleeping for the baisa. We have the students, we have the counselor, everybody will be here. So inshallah we will have a general class, I don't know what's about, but we're going to sit and talk, inshallah. Alright? Yes, Sister Zainab. Yeah, we cancel the shura, we postpone the shura meeting to the Wednesday, because most of the members of shura out also. Okay? Thank you very much. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa an. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayka.